You are now entering Phase 10, November 26th through December 5th. Fittingly titled Green Revisited, this phase exemplifies the importance of your biologic plots. Those mature bucks, exhausted from the process of breeding, now need to regenerate, and there's one place that they're sure to be. So, just choose your tactics with that in mind, and you'll find the odds are definitely stacked in your favor. That is, if I don't get in your way.
You go through the party's over, and you don't see deer movement or very much deer movement for 4 or 5 days, and you think, well, it's over. And then all of a sudden, here's another one of those light switch events where they start moving quite well again.
Green Revisited, albeit a short window, is probably one of the best opportunities to harvest a mature deer.
I remember when we first started talking about the fact that deer came back to green during this phase, and we really didn't understand why. And then we started breaking down all of these different phases, and we said, you know what? They've already been with the does. They've gone through desperately seeking. They go through this period where they literally don't move at all for 4, 5, 6 days. And now all of a sudden, it's time to start recharging that battery.
All of a sudden, it's more about feeding than it is about breeding. Almost as if they want to get away from the rest of the does or rest of that herd.
What's the first food source they get back on? It's green. If you plant for it, you can have dramatic results during this short phase.
It might have something to do with the moisture content. It definitely has a lot to do with that protein level. If it's highly palatable, your pH is correct, you're gonna have some mature deer on that green food source.
What coincides with this phase? Temperatures that are very, very cold and the ground starts to freeze. You get a heavy frost every single morning. All of a sudden that plant starts to break down and those deer come to them like they're candy. The other thing that's magical about this time, if the bucks still do have a little rut on their mind, they're going where all the gals are, and those gals are going to green during this phase. Year in and year out, we started moving our cameras onto these green food sources or a scrape next to that green food source, and all of a sudden, monsters start showing up.
During this period, you may see them hitting that tree at 4 p.m., 4:30, and if you see it 2 or 3 days in a row, pretty good chance he is living and bedding right there.
But it is a phase that's easy to miss. You're wore down just like the deer are, and for years we missed it, but we don't miss it anymore, and you'll find out why.